everyone, welcome you all to Imagination Gallery. Here we try to show you different types of drawings and stories behind it. So if you are an art lover and wants to know the unknown facts, press the subscribe button now.
Now let me introduce you to today's topic. Today in our Indian Heritage Art series, we will experience the encapsulating the essence of tribal art of India, which is renowned for their beautiful paintings, vibrant hues, and intriguing patterns. It's Gond tribal art from Madhya Pradesh. So keep an eye till the end of the video to see this beautiful painting and listen to the stories behind it. Here's presenting Gond tribal art. My bosom buddies, the boundaries of Indian art are so large and rich that it takes days and nights for somebody to discuss over it. And India has a rich legacy of folk and tribal art that we have been reached the international markets as well. Some of India's most famous folk art forms are Warli, Madhubani, Chitra, Pattachitra, Mandana and Gond art. Its beauty and underlying meaning fascinate people since over centuries now. And one such painting is Gond art painting. Gonds are renowned for their beautiful paintings, which are characterized by vibrant hues and intriguing patterns. And in the meantime, I just want to say that we have done already two videos on Gond painting before, on 5th May and 10th March this year. And you must watch those videos, those two videos also, and let us know about it. Now, in this painting, I have tried to kind of portray the traditional Gond patterns with a kind of, you can say, scenery with Gond people, elephant, tree of life, etc. I am frenzied to start this with you all. Let's begin. Gond paintings are a form of painting from folk and tribal art that is practiced by one of the largest tribes in India, with whom it shares its name. While Gond paintings are considered to be from predominantly Madhya Pradesh, it is also quite common in Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, Chhattisgarh and Odisha. To me, the most striking feature of this art is the intricate, painstakingly drawn patterns that detail each life form on the canvas. Dots, dashes and curved lines are most common designs. Elements of nature detailed with repeating patterns are the most recognizable feature of this Gond art. And friends, you know, according to the Gond belief system, each and everything, whether it is a hill, river, rock or a tree, is inhabited by a spirit and consequently is sacred. So the Gond people paint them as a form of respect and reverence. Gond paintings are a reflection of man's close connection with his natural surroundings. Gond paintings can also take inspiration from myths and legends of India, or alternatively, they may also showcase images from the daily lives of the tribe. So it is not only limited to nature, but they can also show the myths and legends of India, tales from India, or the daily lives of them. It can also showcase abstract concepts like emotion, dreams and imagination. Now, you know, history about Gond art and Gond people are also very interesting. Painting in the region has been happening for a really long time, as the history of the Gond people dates nearly 1400 years previously. However, the Gond people could just be imitating their ancestors, as they are cave paintings. There are cave paintings in the region that go all the way back to the Mesolithic period. Paintings as well as the other art forms have always been quite popular with the tribal people in India, whatever the tribe is, you know, especially the Gond tribe, if we talk about. Even amongst the Gond people, it was most prominent among the Pradhan Gonds, who were renowned for their artistic skills, be it painting or music. The Gond people have a belief that viewing a good image begets good luck. So this belief led to the Gond people to decorate the walls as well as the floor of their houses with the traditional tattoos and motifs. Gond paintings have also been used by the Gond people as a way to record their history. So imagine one painting and so many inspiration bound to this. So many interests are attached with it. And right now, my dear friends, today I'm gonna give you some mind-blowing facts about Gond art and Gondi people. So, number one is, Gond people may have featured in the book Jungle Book by Rudyard Kipling. As I have learned from somewhere, there was a Gondi hunter who was one of the victims of King's Ankush, and a Gondi diviner who advised the local villager. And number two is, Gonds are thought to be the descendants of Ravan. The explanation appears to be that the Hindus considered the Gonds to have been the enemy encountered by Rama and his group in the Aryan expedition. And number three, Gonds have numbered their gods. So there is a number system for their gods. So they have a total 9 group of gods. From 1 to 7 and from 12 and 6, from 1 to 7, 12 and 6. Members belonging to the lineage of the even numbered group of gods were permitted to marry only those 2 odd number groups. So really interesting this is. And number four is, Gond myths and legends are preserved. Gond myths and legends are preserved by hereditary bards and professional storytellers called Pradhans. All Gond traditions are oral, and consequently numerous variations of the same tales are recounted. Yet, it is in mythology and the deeds of Gond heroes that the social norms of Gond society are rooted. And last one which I have collected is, the music and song and dance play an important role in Gond society. Gonds are ardent dancers, and all festive occasions are celebrated by song and dance. In some instances, such as the Dandari dances celebrate the dramatic retelling of events from Gond mythology. So from mythological tales and oral histories to traditional songs, natural surroundings, important events and rituals, and Gond artists recreate the past with intense mastery of technique and profound intricacy. Gond paintings are known for their rich detail, bright colors, embedded mystery, and a taste of humor. The Gonds believe that viewing good images brought in good luck. Thus, traditionally, they painted motifs tattoos and images on the floor and walls of their houses. Their paintings are also a means to record and pass the historical knowledge and teachings. Such interesting and cultural heritage paintings you can only find in Imagination Gallery. Imagination Gallery will always try to adorn the Indian heritage and culture and the paintings. And our simple life is obviously is one of the first footsteps of our golden heritage.
Enjoyed and liked today's fascinating journey of an Indian heritage, Gone Tribal Art. Transmit your feedbacks and suggestions about our drawing session here in the comment box. So if you like our drawing session and you want to know about different illustrations and paintings and the stories behind it, then do not forget to subscribe our channel. Here is wishing you an amazing week. Stay safe and take care of yourself, my friends. Bye-bye.